Hey everybody, for all of you pineapple lovers out there, I have a special recipe for you today. We're making pineapple cookies. Let me tell you the ingredients, and I'm going to post my recipe so you don't have to write it down. You can just watch this video. I'm using solid shortening, white granulated sugar, an egg, 8 ounces of crushed pineapple with the juice, all-purpose flour, and to that all-purpose flour, I'm going to add baking soda, salt, and 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, and 1/2 cup of chopped pecans. So these cookies are going to be delicious. It's a little process. We're going to have to put the dough in the refrigerator for at least an hour, which that'll be fine, but let's come together now around the island and let's start making these cookies together. The first thing that we're going to do is to cream our solid shortening and our sugar together. And I'm using my electric hand mixer to do this. I'll turn it up a little bit so that we can kind of speed the process. So that's 1 cup of solid shortening and 1 1/2 cups of sugar. And like I said, the recipe will be on the front of my video at the very beginning. You can just take a snapshot of that and save it for later, and then you can enjoy watching my video. For a long time I wasn't able to do that, and now I am, and I'm so happy. And so many of you have told me how glad you are that I'm able to do that as well. So I'm just mixing my sugar and my solid shortening together. Next, I'm going to add 1 egg to the sugar and the solid shortening. Just mixing this around. I know all of you are probably busy taking down Christmas decorations and getting ready for the new year, and probably eating some leftovers and trying to get rid of those. And what I like to do, if I don't use all of mine, I like to put some of mine in the freezer and then I can have them to enjoy later. But this will be a nice, delightful cookie that you can have to serve around New Year's. So now let's add 8 ounces of pineapple, and we're adding the juice. This is about 1 cup. That's what you want, is 1 cup of crushed pineapple with the juice. Ooh, this is smelling yummy. Hope you can smell it. This is so quick and easy. I mean, it's just unbelievable how quick and easy it is to mix this up. Okay, that looks good. So next, we're going to start adding our flour. And remember, I sift my flour and then I measure it. So I've sifted the flour, I've measured it, and then I added the other dry ingredients. I put my flour back in the sifter, and I added the other dry ingredients, and I re-sifted all of the dry ingredients together and set them aside before I actually started making the cookie dough. So I'm going to work to put the rest of the flour in the cookie dough, and when I get that done, I'll be back. I have finished adding and mixing in our dry ingredients, and I wanted to show you the consistency of this. See, it's kind of like a batter rather than a dough, and that's the reason that it needs to go in the refrigerator for at least 1 hour before we start dipping our cookies onto a cookie sheet. So now all we have to do is add our chopped pecans, and I'm adding 1/2 cup. You could add more if you wanted to, but look how delicious this is looking. Oh my goodness, it's just gonna be so good, so good. So now that I have all of this mixed up, I'm going to put it in the refrigerator, and when it gets chilled, I'll come back and we'll drop it onto our cookie sheet and bake our pineapple cookies. I have preheated our oven to 375 degrees. We need to cook these kind of fast, and I have sprayed and brushed my cookie sheet. I used a nonstick spray to do that with. And now I'm just taking, after our dough has been in the refrigerator for over an hour, actually mine has been in there longer than that because I had some errands that I had to run. Now I'm just taking a teaspoon and I'm dipping about probably 1 inch round. And I'm not rolling these today because this cookie dough is more moist than the regular cookie dough because of the pineapple and the pineapple juice that's in it. So I'm just dipping it, placing the little rounds about 2 inches apart, and I'm going to finish doing this. I will bake the first batch of cookies, and when they get done, I'll come back and we'll look at them together and see how they're looking. Our first batch of cookies are ready to come out of the oven. I have cooked them 10 minutes, and you just want them to be firm to the touch so that it doesn't indent when you touch the cookie. So these are ready to come out of the oven. Our cookies are all done. Look, we have a tray full, or a cooling rack rather, full of cookies. Now these cookies are crunchy on the outside and soft in the middle. So that's going to be a favorite for a lot of you. Some people like a crunchy cookie, some people like a soft cookie, and this is a combination. So you get two in one. Okay, we're finished with our pineapple cookies. Look at this large amount of cookies that this one recipe made. I'm gonna share mine, and I know that you're gonna share yours too when you make them. I'm also gonna put some in the freezer. I love to keep cookies in the refrigerator and in the freezer, so I can just go to them when I don't have any in the pantry and just pull them out, or in the cookie jar. So now let's taste one. This one looks good here. They all look good. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for sharing our videos. And now let's taste this cookie. Mmm, that is so soft. That would be so good with a cup of coffee, a glass of milk, a cup of hot cider. Oh my goodness, that would be delicious. See you again really, really soon.